microprocessor.
The most scientifically engineered marquee in history and most beautiful.
Produced by Soundman and NVX Audio. Premium iPad dash kits and custom dash mods at soundman.co. High quality car stereo, amp speakers, and vehicle specific bass packages.
Bass!
NVX.com. We are also sponsored by high output alternators and power control modules. Upgrade your charging system at usalternators.com. Fastest shipping, best prices on the biggest brands from an authorized dealer. Go to downforsoundshop.com. And Tim's Stereo. Upgrade your Harley Davidson stereo system with the best components and workmanship in the country. Send your bike to Tim's Stereo.
Oh! We've got a giant amp, power supply unit, speakers, DSP, knob.
Today I'm bench testing my new stereo system. What if it doesn't work?
Ooh, take a look at this. We have an iPad. An Apple multi-dongle. Check this little baby out. This is the Cubilux. Take a look at this. Look at this. Wait till you see this. Okay, we're gonna get into this little bag. Look at this. This is a USB to optical. So we're gonna give this a test tickle.
This Apple AV multi-dongle device will allow me to connect an iPad charger and the Cubilux optical adapter simultaneously. My latest discovery, you're welcome again.
Optical cable. Okay, now here's the idea. Now we want the capability of high resolution audio. I have this here RSX GS9 that is capable of high res DSD 5.0 megahertz files, but we're gonna start at the source. There's barely any music you can get that is a DSD 5.0 megahertz file. So I'm like, what can I play music from?
I keep saying 5.0 megahertz. I meant 5.6 megahertz. So shut your mouth about it. I don't want to see any comments about saying I fucked up. All right?
What can I play music from that's actually going to give me high res? What's the bit rate going to be? What's the bits? What's the specs on the music? So I checked out Cobuzz. Okay? Now look at this. Cobuzz has high res files. Ooh. 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 Ooh, ooh. Okay, now see this here file is a high-res 24-bit 48 kilohertz stream. In the settings of this app, we're able to choose our quality. Now the audio control DSP is capable of 24-bit 96 kilohertz. So we could set the app to 24-bit 96 kilohertz. Depending on what the iPad plays, some tracks that they have are available in high res, some are not. We got Luna's I Got Five on it, CD quality, which is a 16-bit 44.1K. So what we need to test here is, we got some Ski Low.
A quality sound system starts with a quality source. Cubuzz is the music app. It plays high bitrate audio files. You could download the files to your device. And most importantly, you can select the output bitrate of the unit.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put this dongle in the dongle. Now when this plays, we're getting light out of the output ski. So we're gonna take this here DSP. Now what I'm worried about is if we switch bit rates on this DSP from one track to the other, how will it handle said changing of the bit rate? Okay, so we're gonna put this in here. We're gonna get this over here. We're gonna get this 20-foot optical cable to test the length. Will it even work with a long cable? We gotta remove the nipple of the cable. Nipple removed. Inserting optical cable into the Cubilux. Insertion complete. Look. We're getting light signal out of the light. Okay, now this is gonna go into here. Where is it? Okay, it's gonna go right into here. Inserting optical. We're gonna give it a test tickle. This says we're playing out of the USB SPDIF adapter. SPDIF-alicious, baby. Okay, let's get this over here. Give me a minute, I'm gonna hook the power supply up to the amp and to the unit. And we can take a look at what if it works, what if it doesn't.
QBuzz on an iPad with the Cubilix optical adapter is my latest source setup that people will be copying for years to come. You're welcome again.
It doesn't matter.
All right, we have power hooked up to the audio control DM810. Power hooked up to the Macintosh MC4000M. I have my iPad dongle hooked up to the charger with the Cubilux optical cable. May as well plug this volume knobberoni in here. Attaching of the knobberoni. I'm gonna plug the power supply on to see if this shit turns on. What if it doesn't even? We have power to this. Ooh yeah, we got lights on the amp. Ooh yeah, the VU meters work. Ooh, bitch. Now I need to connect something to this audio control piece. See if we can get it adjusted and adjustable.
Ooh!
Got an Apple MacBook Slow. Connecting hub. Other side. Hub connected. There's a firmware version ready to be updated. Update firmware. Please wait while firmware is upgrading. All right, I talked to my amp rebuilder. I may send the Macintosh to get refurbished and upgraded. He wants me to test for DC offset. If a particular channel is over 1 volt DC, then don't even bother testing that channel for audio. So we're gonna see if anything's wrong with the amp before we hook up the speakers. We have signal from our optical in. The optical in uses channel 7 and 8, so we could turn off. So I'm just gonna mute these other channels just in case. What if we get some extraneous waves coming in? This is Robot Rock by Daft Punk. Give me a minute, I'm gonna see if this app has an update. It might update the firmware again. We're gonna test the DC offset of the Pimplifier. If that's okay, we're gonna move on to hook up the speakers and get a test situation going on. We need to see if I switch bit rates from one song to the next, how that works through the DSP. Make sure we don't have any errors or problems. Because if we have any problems, we can't use this as a source, this particular setup. Do you get me? Do you get what I'm getting at? All right, we're testing DC offset channel 1. This is in set to millivolts, as long as we don't have 1 volt DC. 2.1 millivolt. Now I have it set to volts, just for shits and giggles. Give it a retest. It looks good, dude. This amp is good still. Look at that. No DC offset problems here, baby. It's good.
An idiot left a comment saying, these car audio channels are copying each other. Saying I copied the GP Car Audio YouTube channel by purchasing a Grand Marquee to build. Bitch, I've had this Grand Marquee for 6 months, hiding it in every video, blacking it out in every video since I bought it. GP Car Audio bought their Grand Marquee a month ago. Who's copying who? And we've been showing my son's Grand Marquee since April 2023. A damn year! GP Car Audio got their white Grand Marquee a month ago.
Oh, I got the magnets too close to my computer and wiped the SSD. All right, we got some speakers hooked up. I updated the app, updated the firmware again. I think we're ready to play some audio. We'll test the remote level controller. First, I'll play a CD quality track. Holy shit. Blew a speaker probably. Oh damn, that doesn't smell so good. I hope I didn't hurt it. Damn, dude, why'd it have to be all the way up?
The volume on the DSP defaulted in the all the way up position, blasted me off my stool, startled my dick off. I blew a Macintosh 6.5 because of you. Smells like burnt voice coil. Cockford Ballsgate!
Holy but Jesus.
It smells like a robot fart. I blew a rare Macintosh 6.5 mid, irreplaceable and rare. If you want to buy it, I'll sell it to you for $600.
All right, that's a CD quality track. High res 96K 24 bit. Right. That's horny. That mid's not sounding so great, guys. This is high res 44.1K, but a 24 bit. It looks like it's behaving fine with switching bit rates back and forth. That sounds really good. We're getting a lot of bandwidth out of the 3-inch, which is really good. This is the frequency range, 20 hertz, 20K. You can see at 500 to 20 kilohertz. The 3-inch is playing the majority of the bandwidth. The mid is only playing from here to here, which is good in our situation because the mid is not in the best spot, but we're only playing from 500 to 80, so that'll work great. Because the mids plan the least of the bandwidth. I set up 5 and 6 and 7 and 8 as an active rear stage in case I want to throw some rear speakers in there. 9 and 10 are a subwoofer, 80 and down. Hell yeah, and our knob works. All right, that works good. So with the Qobuz app, I'm able to get high-res files. Not everything's available in high-res, so we can play CD quality sound. Some songs will be CD quality sound. This is passing digital audio out through the optical cable, which disables volume control on the iPad, which is also kind of nice. So we don't have to worry about where the iPad level is at. It's just straight passing digital signal into the DSP. The DSP has a sampling rate of up to 24-bit, 96 kilohertz. We set the app to output at a maximum of 24-bit, 96K. It's letting us play a variety of bit rates without any problems. Sometimes if you have the source and the preamp set at different bit rates, you'll get a crackling sound if it's switching, but this seems to handle it correctly. Now what would be nice is if I can get the iPad app to link to the Bluetooth adapter. That might work since we updated the firmware, because it'd be nice to pull the DSP up on the iPad that's in the dash. What if I wanna adjust my Linkwitz Riley crossover on the fly? That's quite swell. So now I'm just gonna dig around, see if I can get the app working with the Bluetooth adapter. Give me a minute. If it doesn't work, I'm not gonna show you that it doesn't work. I'm just gonna try it.
GP Car Audio copied me and bought a white Grand Marquis, the same one I've had for a year. And my new Grand Marquis is the premium trim level. They don't have a premium trim level Grand Marquis with a center console and a sunroof. Factory sunroof! And enhanced side moldings. Plus, they're gonna be doing a bunch of gay shit to their Grand Marquis, building a nerd car. They're not building no optical Macintosh system.
Ooh, the signal sounds good, baby. Ooh. Damn, these hybrid 3s sound good as fuck. And the signal is crystal clear. We're watching Cat Williams on Joe Rogan. What's good is we don't have any audio delay with the image. Sometimes over Bluetooth, depending on your Bluetooth receiver, the voice could be off sync from the video that you're watching. But this lines up and syncs fantastically. Another thing we have set up is we have this shortcuts app here. I set up two shortcuts here. When iPad is connected or disconnected from power, it plays and pauses audio. When iPad is disconnected from power, it locks the screen. So right now I have it set so that the iPad screen doesn't sleep when it's unlocked. That way when I'm rolling in the car, my screen stays on. So if we have a song playing and we lose power when the key's turned off, pauses, locks the screen. Then once the screen's locked, the screen will automatically shut off when it times out. See that? Now when power is reconnected, when we turn the key on, iPad screen comes on, starts playing audio. Then I can just unlock from there if I choose. So that's a bitchin' setup. We got a source for high-res files. iPad turns on and off with the key, starts playing audio and stops playing audio. We're getting crystal clear digital optical signal. Now what's cool is you could have your music going here. Bam. Swipe up, take the Maps app. Get some navigation going on the side here. In case I gotta navigate, split screen action. Check out the Cobuzz app. In my F-150, I had the Sony head unit in there that was capable of DSD 5.0 megahertz files, which I downloaded and tried and they sound good, but no music is available in that format. The Cobuzz has everything. Some of it's CD quality sound if you're looking for older hip hop, which is probably the highest bit rate that it's available in. But they do have a lot of high res music. They got Fleetwood Mac over here, 24 bit, 96 kilohertz. It's horny. This will be a fun system to tune when it's all in the car. We got some Adele off the 007 soundtrack. High res 96 kilohertz.
I ain't copying shit, bitch. GP Car Audio's not building a high res iPad Macintosh audio system with a made in the USA Class A amplifier. They're using Chinese speakers and a Chinesium amp. They should name their build the Grand Bangkok Marquee. I'm sure it'll bang. Bangkok. With a cheap Chinese amp. I have a true Class A amplifier. They're using a Class D amplifier. D for dumpling. Made in China, cheap piece of shit. Chinese piece of ching chong shit.
Hell yeah, we're connected to the DSP over Bluetooth from the iPad. That's fucking awesome, dude. Now I can dick with my EQ while I'm driving. Oh, that's fucking cool. I could tune it from the iPad. I get a sphincter analyzer on my dash.
In dash sphincter analyzing capabilities is what you're looking at.
A sphincter analyzer. My input gain doesn't do anything because it's digital in. We got Vanilla Ice, high res, 24-bit, 96K, baby. Oh, shit.
I'm using oxygen-free American wire to connect my system. They're using chow mein noodles. it works.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
Oh, right.
People.
Roger, this is...
Man.
What happened to your sense of humor?
I got my sense of humor. That was what my sense of humor was.
Man.
What happened to...